Hello and happy Friday. My name is Alison Feigh with Jacob Wetterling Resource Center. And as we've been reading books every Friday for the last few months, we're going to be doing another book today. And this is actually one of the books that I've written. It's called I Can Play It Safe, written by Alison Feigh and illustrated by Laura Logan. I love when you see illustrations. Laura draws kids with red, ruddy cheeks, and I have red, ruddy cheeks. So we sort of match in that way. I like that. But this is a book about safety, and it's one that you can use at home to talk to with the people who take care of you. I Can Play It Safe. And this book is dedicated to all the families who attend our family gathering each year and whose children provide the energy and focus to do the work that we do. So the book starts with some tips for parents and caregivers and some safety rules for kids and things like that. We're going to go right into what the part for kids. I'm going to start with this wonderful picture. It says, when I am playing and having fun, I sometimes imagine that I'm an airplane zooming across the sky. I explore the world and fly faster than the birds. Do you ever pretend that you're an airplane? I like when I'm driving, sort of put my hand out the window a little bit and feel that feeling in my hand like it's an airplane. I know that even an airplane makes a plan for its trip. So it always checks in with the control tower before taking off and when it comes back home. Do you see back here, the airplane has to check in to make sure that it's safe when it's going and check in to come back so that they know, so the people in the control tower know where the plane is. So I remember to check my plans with the person who takes care of me. I check in before I go anywhere. I check in again when I get back. Great. So just like we can pretend to be an airplane, it also reminds us about checking in. Sometimes I pretend that I'm a tiger, creeping through the jungle and growling at the other animals. I am warning them to be careful and stay away from trouble. Can I hear your best tiger roar? Louder. Nice. All animals have instincts that warn them when there's trouble. If I get an uh-oh feeling inside of me, I hurry away and talk to the person taking care of me. I know I can roar for help when I feel like something's very wrong by shouting things like help or call 911 or fire. And you can see that she's worried in this situation that the cat is gonna knock over the candle and get the curtain. So she's using her tiger voice from her gut to ask for help. We don't scream when we need help because people tune that out. When I hear a kid screaming in the store, I usually think that they just need a nap or need some, you know, they're having something, a problem like that. But if I hear a yelling from the gut, most grown-ups want to help kids who need help. They just need to know that they need help. So I listen for that gut yell, just like the tiger. I like to be a detective. I pay careful attention to the people around me, and I write down what I see in my private detective notebook. Ooh, you ever read the book Harriet the Spy or Encyclopedia Brown? There are a lot of great books about kid detectives. Detectives are good at being quiet, but I know sometimes it's important to speak up. I can keep quiet about a surprise, like what someone's going to get for their birthday, but I know the difference between a secret and a surprise. If anyone, even someone I know, asked me to keep a secret from my parents, the person who takes care of me, I talk to a grown-up right away. So we don't keep secrets from the person who takes care of us. If someone's asking us to keep a secret, especially if it's against a rule, that's a problem. We're allowed to talk about it. Surprises, things we don't tell for a very little bit of time, then everyone finds out together, those are different. And if you're not sure, you can ask one of your five grown-ups who can help you. I'll talk about that. Oh, I like this picture. Kind of dogs. Dogs are, I'm a big fan of dogs. I imagine that I'm a boat captain. I carefully sail my boat around the rocks and through the choppy waters. This is a good time of year when people are spending time in the water. Just like the captain takes care of the boat, I can take care of my body. I know that my private areas, the parts covered by my swimsuit, are my own. If anyone touches me in a way that makes me feel bad or confused, I talk to an adult I trust. I know it isn't my fault if someone tricks me into a confusing or a harmful touch. So most people know the rules about bodies, about safety, but you might meet a grown-up or a kid your age who doesn't know the rules about touches. And the one, just a good thing to remember is that we talk about touches. Touches are never a secret. So if someone's trying to touch your private parts or wants you to touch their private parts or anything about private parts, and especially if, you know, if Well, in any case, we want to check in with the person who takes care of us. If it's the person who takes care of us who's doing that and making us feel confused or scared or just uncomfortable, we can talk to any other grown-up. But the good news is that we know most people do know the rules about bodies. So if you meet someone who doesn't know the rules about touches, we can talk to someone who does. Now I'm a superhero. I rescue the good guys from danger and I help a lot of people feel safe. Do you have a favorite superhero? I know adults don't usually ask kids for help. If an adult asks me for help, like how to find something or for directions, I first check in with a parent to see if it's safe for me to help. Of course, superheroes still need to make their beds and put away their toys. Being asked to do chores for the family is different from being asked to help with an adult problem. So if an adult that you know or don't know approaches you and asks you to help you with something, check in with the person who takes care of you first. You know, if the neighbor says, hey, can you help me? My cat had kittens and I need another set of hands to help. First, go check in with who's taking care of you so they know where you are and they know what's happening. Because usually adults ask other adults for help, but we just need to get adults involved if that's happening. Ooh, here's a great picture from Minnesota, and it's a very hot July. And so sometimes we can imagine moments like these. I am a snowflake falling slowly from the sky and landing gently on the ground. Look at all those fun winter sports happening. Each snowflake is different from the rest. All kids are different too. I'm the only one of me in the world. I know that I am one of a kind and I should be treated with kindness and respect. Every person is different. Every person has different dreams, different goals, different likes. And it's important that we work on being kind. I can be a butterfly, safely flying from one person I love to another. I know that there are grown-ups in my life who love me and want the best for me. They help me learn and help me try new things. If I'm sad, they cheer me up. If I'm lonely, they play with me. If I'm scared, they comfort me and explain things to me. If anyone tries to hurt me, I can talk right away to one of the grown-ups I trust. So we talk about having like a safety net of five grown-ups. So if you're walking through your day and you meet someone who doesn't know the rules, you have five different people you can talk to. We say five because sometimes it's the person on the net who's forgotten the rules and we have four more. And we say five because sometimes the first person we tell doesn't know how to help us. And so we want to make sure every kid has a safety net of five. And so pause the video if you haven't talked about this with your family yet and make a list of who you think your five safety net people are. Maybe you can trace your hand and draw their faces and talk to people who take care of you and see if they agree that that's a good solid safety net, because most people do know the rules and do want kids to feel safe. It is good to know that there are people who love me, whether I'm an airplane, a tiger, a detective, a boat captain, a superhero, a snowflake, a butterfly, or just me. And just me is just great. So thank you so much. I always want to give a shout out to Free Spirit Publishing, who does a great job of putting out books for kids. And thank you for being with me today. We talk about the 11 for Jacob, and we think about the different 11 traits that we try to work on, you know, being a good friend, being kind, being understanding. And so I ask you this week to think about those 11 traits and decide which one you're going to work on. In the book, they talked a lot about, you know, the importance of being allowed to talk about things and sometimes things that can be hard to talk about. And that's a part of being understanding, is talking about hard things sometimes. And know that if you meet someone who doesn't know the rules, this book is called I Can Play It Safe. If you know someone who isn't playing it safe or has forgotten the rules, it's not your fault and you can tell someone about it. Thanks so much for tuning in today. Take care.